everyone. Jason Shaver here, MzeroA.com, alongside our director of maintenance, Russell Loving. Russ is going to be my student today. We're going to show spatial disorientation, recovery from an unusual attitude is what we're after. There's two ways instructors do it. I'm going to show you both ways and why I favor one over the other. So, Russ, if you want to get those foggles on, I'll fly the airplane for a second here.
Your flight controls?
All right, I have the flight controls.
You got the flight controls.
I got them. All right, all looking good. Let you get adjusted here for a second. Everything good?
Yep, I got the flight controls.
All right, you have the flight controls.
I got the flight controls.
All right, great. So this is how I do it first. Now, I always situate, Russ, you're just flying the airplane along here. No, just hold this heading here. That's fine. Altitude's great, 130, 3,500 feet. Everything looks great here. All right, how I typically do it with work with students here on this is I want you to, you know, induce yourself into spatial disorientation, because that's how it's really going to happen. The second method we do, where instructors kind of just fly the airplane around and then say recover, well, that's a little different. What I like to do is this. So, Russ, I want you to close your eyes and put your chin to your chest, but continue to fly the airplane. And just keep flying the airplane. If you rub your eyes outside, we've already done clearing turns, everything's all good, don't you worry about it. Eyes closed, chin to your chest. Russ, I want you to give me what you think is just a standard rate turn to the left, please. That's a standard rate turn. Good thing you know your left from right. We're off to a good start so far. Looking good. Nice. Standard rate turn to the left. All right, Russ, give me what you think is just a standard rate climbing right turn. All right. Everything's looking good. And again, this is why I do this way, because you would be flying the airplane. You would be putting yourself in this situation. Now, you guys are all watching this go, I told Russ to do a climbing right turn, and you're all looking and laughing right now as to where we're going. Russ is probably laughing right now, too, because he has no idea where we're going. So, as we continue this, Russ, why don't you give me a descending left turn? Russ, go ahead and recover. We're nose down, power comes back, power comes back, and we smoothly bring that on up. Nice work here. A little different, huh, Russ?
Yes, I thought we were actually in a climb.
I was well aware that that's what you thought. Go ahead, give it power, Russ, on this recovery. Nice work here. All right. Now we're going to do it a different way here. This is how it's typically done, where the instructor induces the spatial disorientation. So, Russ, if I could have the flight controls for a second, please.
All right, you have the flight controls?
I have the flight controls.
You got the flight controls.
All righty, let's see. So, Russ, you're just going to, it's like monkey see, monkey do. You're just going to do what I say here. Ready?
All right.
So, let me just double check the area since we spun around here a little bit. So, Russ, still... eyes closed, chin to your chest, please, here for a bit. We're just flying along straight and level. Russ, when I say go, I want you to put your left ear to your left shoulder.
All right.
Ready, go. And you see now, I'm inducing Russ, and you see what I'm doing with the inner ear. You see why I'm having Russ move his head around here. Instructors like this because instructors like whipping the airplane around and messing with their students' heads. Instructors are strange people sometimes, right? So anyways, while this is all happening, allowing some of that that fluid to stabilize in Russ's inner ear as we come around, Russ, when I say go, I want you to go ahead and take your right ear to your right shoulder. Ready? Go. Ooh.
Oh, wow.
You ever been upside down, Russ, before?
Nope.
You just did it real quick there. All right, and we're coming around here. That'll mess with your head a little bit, huh, Russ?
Yes, it will.
All right, Russ, when I say go, I want you very carefully to put the back of your head to the back of the seat. Ready? Go. And Russ, your airplane, recover.
Oh, woo!
Woo! There you go. Good job. How'd that feel?
For a second, I thought I was tumbling. that is crazy.
That is the purpose of it. Two different ways to practice spatial disorientation here. It doesn't matter which you use. Both, as you saw, were quite effective here. But I encourage you to use both. What's going to happen in the real world? You're going to fly yourself into that spatial disorientation. So that's what I want you to really think about. So listen, can't wait to read your comments below this video on Facebook, on YouTube, on MZeroA.com. Enjoy the rest of your day. And most importantly, remember, the good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, guys. We'll see ya.
Pass your check ride or I'll pay for it. Join our number one rated online ground school and participate in live mock check rides and interactive written test prep. Visit groundschoolacademy.com to learn more.